Dr. Jones, thank you so much for coming today to speak with us at the 2017 Connective Tissue Oncology Conference. We appreciate your time and sharing your thoughts of the future of leiomyosarcoma research. And thank you for being with us today.
Pleasure to be here.
Dr. Jones is the head of the sarcoma clinical trials at the Institute of Cancer Research at the Royal Marsden Hospital in London. Thank you, Dr. Jones.
Thank you.
My first question is, as of today, what do you feel are the best treatment options for LMS depending on the location of the primary site of the tumor?
So for localized disease, the optimal treatment is surgery, complete surgical resection with or without radiation treatments. In some instances, we use chemotherapy treatment as well, but that's more of an individualized decision. When the cancer is spread elsewhere, there are a number of options that can be considered. There are a number of lines of systemic therapy, chemotherapy type treatments, but we can also use techniques like radiation, radiofrequency ablation, and surgery as well. So I'd say that those are the optimal treatments in both the localized and metastatic setting.
And what dictates whether there should be radiation first or before?
That tends to vary according to the size, the grade, the location of the tumor. In general, at our institution, we try to use radiation first, followed by surgery.
The second question is, metabolic alterations in LMS. Is this an important focus to potentially increase treatment protocols?
Yes, I think this is a really fertile area for research. There's a lot that we don't know about this right now, but I think that this will become increasingly more important as the years go by.
What makes LMS so difficult in terms of harnessing immunotherapy treatments as compared to other sarcoma subtypes?
Yeah, that's a really good question in terms of why, with the provisional data that we have available, LMS seems to be less responsive to PD-1 inhibitors than certain other tumor types and certain other types of sarcomas. I think that there are a number of ongoing preclinical and clinical studies that will hopefully give us an answer to this question, but right now we don't know for sure.
And are there new immunotherapy possibilities on the horizon besides the potential for Keytruda and
Lenvima? There are certainly a number of clinical trials which will include patients with leiomyosarcoma that will look into other immunotherapy drugs and immunotherapy combinations for patients with leiomyosarcoma.
And aldadoxorubicin recently approved. Is that being utilized now compared to?
I think in the United States, yes, but not yet in the UK. But again, time will tell.
Mm-hmm. And I know they're going to be doing studies to see if aldadoxorubicin and Olara could possibly be combined. Is there potential for that?
Yes, that would be a very interesting potential. Particularly with the phase 2 trial of olaratumab using 8 cycles of the combination. Of course, with aldoxorubicin, there's a possibility of carrying on for more than 6 cycles of aldoxorubicin. It would be really interesting to see what the synergy is between aldoxorubicin and olaratumab.
Do you foresee any kind of a maintenance vaccine after treatment is completed to try to stave off recurrence?
I think the use of olaratumab and leiomyosarcoma in a way is maintenance therapy after combination therapy with doxorubicin. In terms of a vaccine, there are other sarcoma subtypes where maintenance therapy with vaccine-based therapy may be helpful, but not yet in leiomyosarcoma.
Because of its complex
profile? Yeah.
Do you feel that genomic sequencing helps to clarify a definitive diagnosis for targeted therapy?
Potentially in certain cases, but not for all patients with IOI sarcoma. I think the results so far have been disappointing in terms of identifying a targetable mutation, but we can see that things are improving all the time in terms of our understanding of these diseases. But right now, I think genomic profiling doesn't always give us clear indication as to how to treat patients with metastatic IOI sarcoma.
Do you see it as a part of a standard of care?
Not right now. I think more work needs to be done.
How about checkpoint inhibitors for LMS, injections to boost antigens and immunity, like the T cell? Is it not there yet for LMS?
As we discussed, the results so far in LMS have been not so promising, but with ongoing laboratory and clinical work, hopefully we'll gain a better understanding of the use of these drugs in LMS, both the single agents and as combinations.
I appreciate your time so much, Dr. Jones.
We
really appreciate it. Because you're part of the forward thinking in precision medicine for sarcoma. So thank you so much.
A pleasure. Thank you.